Morning students, this is today's video is about for class 5 science chapter of the skeletal system. This is the part 1 of this chapter, video part 1. Now today in this chapter we will study and discuss about the skeletal system of our body. Now to begin with this chapter, first of all we have to discuss some general topics like organism. And the organisms are made of organ system. Organ systems comprises of organs, and organs are made up of cells, that is tissues, that is cells. Now, first of all, the organism. What is the meaning of organism? All the living being, living organism means all the living things like animals, human beings, all are called as organisms. Plant also comes under living organism, but we are not talking about plant. We are talking about the animal kingdom. So here, the organism will just see the animal kingdom. Whereas now, the body of an animal or living organism is made up of organ system. There are 5 organ systems in our body. They are digestive system, circulatory system, excretory system, nervous system and skeletal system. Now today's topic is about the skeletal system. Today we will see only the skeletal system, and these topics will be covered in some other chapters. Now the system, organ system. Each organ system are made up of individual and single organs. Now what are the organs? You may take an example like lungs, heart, kidney, liver. These are all the organs, means which have got a specific and fixed function for which those functions are performed by those organs. That means each and every organs have got some specific function. They perform those functions and run the system efficiently and without any problems. So these organs, and organs are made up of cells. That is tissue. Now what is tissue? Tissue are also the cells. A group of cells which have a particular and specific function is called as tissue. And those tissue are also a cell. If we talk about individually, we can say cell. The smallest particle by which the human or the body of human organism or any living organism are made is called cell. So those cells, when they cluster and become group, they perform a single and specific function, then those group of cells is termed as tissue. But organisms are made up of organ systems. There are 5 organ systems in the human body. And each organ systems are made up of different organs. And each organs are made up of tissue, that is cell. Now here, if I talk about digestive system, there are different types of organs which works under the digestive system, circulatory system, different types of organs which comes under or works under circulatory system. Here bone is also, as we can say, that bone is also an organ. Even blood is also an organ, because blood is made up of blood cells, that is tissue. Bone is also an organ, because bones are made up of bone cells, that is tissue. So organism, organ system, organs and tissue. Now here in this organism we will talk about skeletal system. Now to start with the skeletal system, first of all we have to see what is a skeleton. A skeleton is the framework of bones which is present inside our body under the skin. एक हड्डियों का ढांचा जो हमारे शरीर के अंदर में है उसे हम लोग कहेंगे skeleton. जैसे हिंदी में हम लोग बोलते हैं कंकाल, that is called skeleton. Now skeleton are made up of different types of bones. स्केलेटन जो हमारे बॉडी के अंदर में है वो अलग अलग किस्मों की हड्डियों से बना हुआ है. Now bones, as I have told you earlier, that bones is also an organ. That means it is made up of cells. It is bone cells, which collectively called as tissue. So bones is also made up of tissue. Now children, why does a human or living organism, like in animal kingdom? Let me take an example of human body. Why do a human body consist skeleton? What is the need of the skeleton inside our body? For this, we have to just understand the function of the skeleton. Number one, it gives the shape to our body. It is because of the skeleton that our body has got a fixed and perfect shape. It protects our internal organs. Whatever soft and delicate organs are there inside our body, which are responsible to run the body as a whole, is protected by the skeletal system. Now, if I talk about the part of the skeleton which will be covered in our next video, if I talk about the part of the skeletal system, there is skull, rib cage, limbs, that is upper limbs and the lower limbs. Got it? And so many parts are there. We will cover that topic in our next upcoming video. So that rib cage is like a cage. एक पिंजरे के जैसा है, हड्डियों का पिंजरा जो हमारे चेस्ट में है. Inside that rib cage, there are certain important, soft and delicate organs are there, like heart, lungs, stomach, liver. These are very crucial and very important organs in our body. So those organs are protected by the skeletal system. How? From the external charge and external injury. Now, the next function is it helps us in movement. Because of the skeleton and the muscle, because of the joint action of the skeleton and the muscle, not only the skeleton, it is the joint action of the muscle and the skeleton. That is, we can say that the coordination of the muscles and the bones that help us to move our body, that help us for movement. These are the functions, and these are very important functions. Because of these only, skeletal system is important for any living organism. So once again, let me discuss the function of the skeleton. It gives shape to our body. The first function is it gives shape to our body. Second is it protects our internal organs. And third, it helps us in movement. It is because of these three important basic functions that skeletal system is so important for us. Now bones, if I talk about bones, this whole skeletal system is made up of bones. The bones are of many. Basic information is that when a child is born, at that time, at infant stage, a child has more than 300 bones in his or her body. But as we grow up to reach to the adult stage, some of the bones get fused, get merged and become single bone. And because of that only, during the stage of growing, the adult stage, some of the bones get fused and become a single bone, and so it gets reduced, and finally it reaches to 206 bones. So we can say that in an adult human body, there are 206 bones. All total, there are 206 bones. And during the infant stage, there are 300 bones are there. Got it now? Now, One more topic is there, that is bone marrow. What is the bone marrow? See, here I have drawn a simple structure of a bone, that is a thigh bone, which is called as femur. This is the longest bone in our body. What is it? This is the femur. This is the longest bone in our body. Now, I have drawn a thigh bone over here. From one gas I have drawn. If I cut this bone over from this position, the structure will become like this. Now, if I magnify, you can see that the half structure of the bone, and here there is a hollow structure inside the bone. In this hollow structure, there is a thick jelly-like substance which is deep brown, reddish brown in color. It is deep reddish brown in color, and it is thick jelly-like substance. That thick jelly-like substance are called as bone marrow. Student, you should remember that it is in this bone marrow the blood cells are created. It is the factory of blood cells, where the blood cells are made. And it fills the bone, the hollow space inside the bone. So this is called as bone marrow. Today, in this video, I will just cover up to this much only, and next time, soon I will come up with one more new video, and that, in that video, I will discuss about the part of our skeleton. There are different parts of here, the part of our skeleton. Now, for this, you may write a definition. The definition are already given in the book itself. If you go, you can easily get the definition from there. Still, I will discuss the definition from the book. You see. Tissues. What is tissue? Tissue are the group of cells. Tissues are nothing but it is a group of cells. Tissues. Tissue is also a cell, but it is not a single cell. It is a group of cells which performs a certain specific function. What is it? Now, if I talk about liver, the liver is also made up of cells. If I talk about lungs, lungs is also made up of cells. If I talk about stomach, stomach is also made up of cells. Now, the type of cell which makes the liver, the function is also specific for that type of cells. Now, if I talk about lungs, the lungs is also made up of cells, group of cells, and the function of those cells are different from the cells of the stomach or the kidneys. So it is because of that, it is the type of cells which makes the organ. The function of those cells will be also different from the different organs. And there are so many different organs out there. So each organ is made up of different types of cells. And if I talk about a specific organ, the function of those cells will be limited to that organ only, and it will not perform the function of other cells by which makes the other type of organs. Means, if I talk about liver, the liver cells performs only the function of the liver. If I talk about lungs, the lungs cells only performs the function of the lungs. It is because of that only the group of cells which perform a specific function, fixed function, those cells are called as tissue as a whole. And if we talk about single particles by which other human body is made, or living organisms are made, is called as cells. The single particle is called as cells, and a group of particles will be termed as tissue, which perform the specific function. What is organ system? Means there are several types organ systems are there. Basically, there are five organ systems are there, and each system performs the different functions, different actions. Now, the organ system means the type of organ which works under the specific system is called as organ system. Now, if I talk about digestive system, here so many organs are involved in this system, like food pipe, interest time. There are two types of interest time, large interest time, small interest time. Then it will be rectum, anus, and so many are there. Tongue is also comes under digestive system, is also an organ. So you see there are so many organs are there which involve these functions under the digestive system, and each organ which coordinates one another. Each organ works to coordinate one another, and by this type of coordination help creates the system to perform a certain function, that is digestion. So it is called as digestive system.
I will give you the definition from where it is given in the book itself.
First to understand the explanation and organs I have already explained you earlier that each organs are made up of tissues and which performs a certain action, a certain functions which coordinates the other organs to perform a certain system. If I talk about the digestive system, it performs the digestion, and cells or tissues are already discussed. Now you may note down this point in your copy by pausing the video, and after this I will give you the definition on the blackboard. You just listen it, understand it, and then you write down those also in your paper copy. Let me run the blackboard. Group of cells that perform certain specific function, organs, a tissue that carry out same task forms an organ, organ system. group of organs that work together and carry out a function. It's called organ system. Got it? Now next, the definition of skeleton. Earlier, I have already given you over here in this position the function of the skeleton. You may note it down in the copy. I am not writing once again the same thing, only I have given you the definition of the skeleton, the meaning of the skeleton. Got it? Now, question that comes in the form of finger blanks, that is dash is the science which deals with the study of bones. The person who study the bone is called as dash. Here you can write it osteology is osteology, an osteologist. The type of question it becomes, so it is very important to write it down. Now the definition of bone marrow in the cyst. Thank you. entire substance inside the hollow space of our bone is called the bone marrow. One more important fact about bone marrow is that it is reddish brown in color blood cells. The jelly-like substance inside the hollow space of our bone is called bone marrow. It is reddish brown in color. It makes the blood cells in our body. These are the definitions, important definitions, which you will have to note it down in your main pair copy. And do learn those definitions and listen the video carefully. Understand it and learn those definitions and get prepared yourself. Okay, for today, in this video, we have just covered some basic information from this chapter. Soon I will come up with one more new video, and in that video I will discuss about the parts of our skeletal system. Got it? So till then, have a good day and goodbye. And do watch the video seriously. Thank you.